Good morning, Purple Room. I wanted to talk to you about something that we put on our Passover tables during Passover time that's really special. And it's called a Seder plate. I have an example of one here. This is sort of a little kid Seder plate. There's all different kinds of Seder plates. There's fancy ones, there's ones you can make yourself for decorations, there's kid ones. And the reason why we put a Seder plate on the table is because it has a lot of different symbols that we use to remind us of why we're celebrating Passover. And I want to show you some of the things you might find on a Seder plate. These are just toy ones, but what does this remind you of? When I first looked at it, it looked like a snowball, but it's not supposed to be a snowball. It's an egg. And an egg is on our Seder plate because it reminds us of the springtime, and that's when Passover happens, and rebirth and new things growing. So that's an egg, and it's called the Beit Sah in Hebrew. So I'm gonna put the egg on the egg part of the Seder plate, right over here. That's where the egg goes. Another thing on the Seder plate is parsley. And in Hebrew, we call it karpas. This is just a pretend one, but it's just little green leaves. And what we do on Passover, we dip the parsley into a bowl of salty water and we take a little bite. And it doesn't taste that great, but that salty water reminds us of tears. Because when you cry, if you ever cried and a tear fell in your mouth and you tasted it, it would taste a little salty. And it reminds us of all the tears that the slaves in Egypt cried because it wasn't fun to be a slave. You had to work really hard for the Pharaoh. So it reminds us of the tears of the Jewish slaves. So I'm gonna put that on the parsley side. It goes right near the egg, karpas. Another thing you find on the Passover Seder plate is something called haroset. And haroset is chopped up apples and some cinnamon. Sometimes it's a little grape juice, or grown-ups use wine, and you chop it all up and it kind of makes like a paste. And you do use apples as a very important ingredient in haroset. So even though this isn't chopped up, we'll think of it as haroset. And the haroset reminds us of the mortar. It's kind of like the glue that the Jewish slaves had to use when they were building all those big buildings for Pharaoh. And they had to get the bricks to stay together. They use that special glue, and the haroset kind of looks like that mixture. So it reminds us of how hard the Jewish slaves had to work. So haroset is gonna go on the Seder plate. Another thing on the Seder plate is the maror, or the bitter herbs. And when you taste a little of this, it tastes bitter. And it's to remind us that life when you're a slave is not fun. It's not good time. So it's kind of bitter and sad. And no one wants to be a slave. So that goes on the Seder plate as well. Over here. And the last thing you can find on a Seder plate, and some Seder plates have more things, but when we do it in the Purple Room, we use these five things. This is called a bone, a shank bone. And in Hebrew, you say zroa. And we put the bone on the Seder plate because a long time ago, a lot of people used bones as offerings to God. And there was also a lot of animals that were important part of the Passover story. So here is a Seder plate, a pretend one. Later today, you can try to make your own Seder plate with your grown-ups. And I want to show you a long time ago when Dylan was in the Purple Room, he made a Seder plate that we still put on our Passover table. And he did it just with things we had around the house. He did, there's the haroset, all those chopped up apples. We just whipped up pieces of paper and he glued them down. This is supposed to be the karpas, the parsley. And he just took some tissue paper and he scrunched it up and glued it in. This is the maror, the bitter herbs. You saw it like this, but when you chop it all up and mush it, it becomes like a paste, like a horseradish. And we just took some little tiny cut up pieces of paper and we glued them in. And then, oh, we use some special kind of clay that hardens. And he made the Beit Sah, the egg. And he took other clay. We put a little bit of brown marker on it and mushed it all around. So it turned sort of a brownish color. And that became the zroa, the bone. And this is a Seder plate that we use to talk about the different symbols of Passover at our own Passover table. Hope you have fun making your own. We can't wait to see pictures of them. Have a good day. Bye.